Hello, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, wherever you are, to our viewers around the world. This is Shinier from Games of the Republic TV, coming at you with another video that I've made. This is specifically about not just my channel, but more so about the newest expansion that's coming out for World of Warcraft, which is called Dragonflight. Now, I have signed up for the beta. And I've been signed up for the beta for the past month or so, and I've been racking up the subscribers, and I've been waiting for Blizzard Entertainment to give me access to the beta, the alpha and stuff. I know other people have gotten the beta access, like this guy right here. Excuse me for a minute. Looks like this guy right here just got it, as you can tell. Looks like he put this video up today, which is July 15th at 2022 at, looks like that was just today he published it. But yeah, no, I'm going to be taking a deep dive into these abilities and stuff, and as much as I can, like, without having the alpha. But when I do, I will, and just so you know, you would want to stay subscribed. If I were you, I'd stay subscribed because there is a lot of more videos coming your way. Because the moment that World of Warcraft, sorry, the moment that Blizzard Entertainment gives me my beta key and allows me to go from, to be able to show where it says all these details here, instead of just from a test realm, it'll show beta right here. That's what happened with Shadowlands when it went in beta, and I covered it. But yeah, so stay subscribed. You do not want to miss that upcoming stuff. Sorry, the upcoming videos that I'm making with this new content. And yeah, as you can see, there's all these other games here. I used to play Overwatch quite a bit, but I kind of lost interest in it for a while. So I've been doing World of Warcraft Shadowlands quite a bit. And yeah, so once World of Warcraft gives me, once Blizzard Entertainment gives me a key, I will go in there and show you. I'll make more videos covering the new content, the new expansion that's coming out, and I'm gonna purchase the legendary bundle, which includes a lot more game time, which I'll show you in a minute. Here, get a little of this. By the way, if you want to know, the music in the background is actually from a game for the Nintendo 64 and also the Xbox 360. And that was an older game, but it's called Banjo-Tooie. It's an older game, but really a lot of stuff from my younger years comes to life when I hear this. It's good stuff. And yeah, so I think I've pretty much covered this stuff before in one of my other videos. But yeah, that looks really, really good right there. I love the wings. I love the sharp edges. I like the talons, the facial expression, or whatever's on the hot top there. It looks really good. They're really customizable, and it just looks amazing. And this is nice. Ride or dive. This is gonna be a lot of fun. And yeah, I'm getting this one right here. This epic edition right here. Here, give it a second to load, and boom, here it comes. I'm gonna buy the epic edition. It's 114, not bad. And here's the comparison between the two. The base edition, you only get three things, but the one that I'm getting, everybody in my guild is getting, is epic edition for $114.99 Canadian, because I'm in Canada. It gives you Dragonflight level character boost, Dreamweaver flying mount, Murkai's Trusted Pet. I hope I'm pronouncing it correctly. It gives you 10 Walker's Hostile Effects, as you can see on here. And also, you get another boost of 30 days of game time to your account. So, that's going to be a little even more fun. You got a really nice Transmog set, which is a lot of fun. I really enjoy that. And it will be a lot of fun. I'm looking forward to the expansion when it goes, when Blizzard Entertainment gives me the key. I wouldn't pre-purchase if I were you, because, they dress it up saying that, oh, it's a kid, you could do this, you could do that. Oh, in-game lore. Yeah, I know they have in-game stuff, but I'm just saying that it's not worth it. Wait until, like, maybe October or November, when this expansion goes live, because it's gonna go live in December. We're talking Christmas time, and it's in the middle of summer right now. Gonna go through two freaking seasons to show this. Okay? You guys might definitely want to wait till Dragonfly drops, or do it just before they drop, and then you can get everything they advertise here. I'll show you my character right now that I have. She's beautiful. I got her up to level 230, I believe. See, this is her. She's level 60 Void Elf Beast Mastery Hunter from the Banner Brigade guild and Dalgun. And that's all the details there. This is my pet. Looks nice. I call him Kickstarter. It's kind of cute. And she's got quite a lot of gear and stuff. And this is our guild. This is where we are. There's we got 725 members, 5,005. And this one right here, she's the guild master. She's a good friend of mine. Her real name is Lisa, by the way. And that's all the details there. It is quite, this is the roster overview, the class breakdowns and stuff. Looks like, I can't remember who that is. I think that's Loppy. Did a really good, numbers there. Miracle breakdowns. But yeah, no, it's gonna be fun. And when it comes, I will be covering this new content, and it will definitely be worth it. See that? Thanks for signing up, Shinira. I told you I was opted in. And because my system is very powerful and I've got really kick-ass internet connection speed, this will not be an issue for me to run. Actually, let's do a check right now. Can I run it? Let's see if I know I can run the current expansion. Let me just pull it up here. Can I run it? Come on, there we go. Warcraft, Shadowlands, Frasma. Where is the... Oh, I guess we can't actually see the new expansion's system requirements until it goes live. But this is the latest one. And yep, minimum requirements, it covers it all. Got an i5 in there. And the CPU is good. Everything in there is good, but I just need a better, maybe an RTX based graphics card if I have the money for it. But this is not bad. But you know, Battle for Azeroth wasn't exactly as memory hungry for like video memory as this one is. But the new expansion, I will show you what the requirements for the new expansion for the new game that's coming out. Excuse me, sorry, I didn't say that right. Requirements for damn it, I can't speak it right. System requirements for Dragonflight. Screw that up. Okay, here we go. This is what they're showing. 4 cores. It's not bad. Here it comes, here's the article. So if you're on Windows, it looks like I meet the requirements, because as you can see right here, I have 6 cores right here. And they have a requirement for 6 cores. The recommended specs is 6 cores, 4 threads. Sorry, 6 cores, I don't know how many threads, but Ryzen Zen 2 and all that. Windows 10 64, but I've got Windows 11, so I'm good with that. A DirectX capable 8GB GPU. It appears you don't need very much for the minimum specs. Okay, let me show you on GPU Z what my current graphics card is. I know it's not as best as it could be. It's just a Contigo graphics card, but it works. See, it's a GTX 1050 Ti. It's got 768 CUDA cores, It's got 4 gigs of dedicated video memory, aka VRAM. And as you can see right there, DirectX 12. It runs DirectX 12 and it supports DirectX 12.1 native, which is good. It's got GDDR5 memory type. These are the clock speeds there. It could do everything but ray tracing. It is meant to integrated graphics. I recently tried out World of Warcraft with the integrated graphics that I have from my processor graphics, and they're not that bad. But I've seen sites on online saying that the alternative to a GTX 1050 Ti, which is the one I have right now, is the integrated graphics that are showing up right here, the Intel UHD Graphics 630. That's a load of bullshit, because when I tried to use the same settings in World of Warcraft for just 1920 by 1080, which is like full HD, not Ultra HD, but anyways, the point is that UHD crap right there, this UHD graphics, it's just a marketing gimmick. I wouldn't recommend looking into that. But yeah, no, it's not bad, but it's definitely going to be a wild ride. But yeah, with the GTX, I wish I had the money to buy an RTX, even a 2060 Super or something, maybe like that. That'd be great. Maybe I can grab something on Amazon. It's okay though. The point is, then there's the Mac specifications right here. Details right here. You have to have 6th generation Intel Core Skylake Apple M1, and I happen to have here. I have the Comet Lake i5 10th gen processor, socket at $1,200 LGA, Core i5 10400, and it's pretty good. It's got all the details there. It's got 6 cores, 12 threads. Not a bad system. And I've got 32 gigs of DDR4 memory, dual channel, that kind of thing, memory and all that. It's pretty good. But yeah, so no, I just wanted to give you a breakdown of what's happening there for this, and just wanted to see here. And this will be fun. Get a little of this. World of Warcraft, Daggerfight's new Volker class feels impressively modern. Yeah, no shit. It's gonna look really good. I mean, it's kind of like the Worgen alternate type deal. Like you could see, like with Worgen, you could choose your form. You could change your form from human to Worgen, and you could change it between the two if you want. This is a similar concept, but it will definitely be a lot more fun. Like I've seen videos of people post on YouTube that who have gotten access to the alpha, papa, beta. I really, really, really would like to get myself a key as well, but I can't. This is how you do it. The in-game drop-down version play button. Choose your Dragonflight Alpha. List under development section. Click install. Blah blah blah. That's all there. And it says when I looked at it on my system here, when they talk about drop-down menu, I don't see that in here. And development just shows the PTR. And the Classic Burning Crusade realm and stuff. There isn't really anything else. So, unfortunately, that's not going to work for me. But that's okay, though. It's just besides the point. Basically, playing the available test servers. Just so you guys know, there's probably going to be a lot of traffic on those servers. So, don't expect a stable connection with World of Warcraft, sorry, Blizzard Entertainment servers. Because I know they're powerful servers, but Brian the Alpha is gonna be quite the not page turner, but it's gonna be quite intense. But yeah, Valular's got it, Platinum Bot's got it. Here, I'll just show you with the video muted here. Take a look. Let me just show it off here. Here we go. This will be fun. That's just the that's how it looks like. It's gonna be fun. I want to get that so bad. I like the fact they got horns on their heads too, on the humans. This will look really good once it comes out. You can change up everything you want. I don't know why it's zooming up like this, but it's okay though. Dragonflight Evoker. Yeah, this is going to be fun when it goes live. To beta testers. Yeah, Dream Breath and stuff. I like that. Yeah, that's Dragon Rider right there. Anyways, yeah, no, I'm just saying that that's what I've been covering, and I will cover once I get my key. Once I get my key, I will activate it, and you guys and girls will not want to miss that, so stay subscribed for future content when I cover the beta, as well as buying the new expansion. Anyways, that's it for today, guys and girls. I just wanted to give you a bit of a download update on what I'm going to be doing, pre-planning with my time. And I just wanted to show that I didn't forget about you or anything. But yeah, kudos, have yourself a good day. And as always, we will see you in the next video. Bye for now.